communication styles that can predict the end of any marriage. But just being aware of them is not enough. In order to find comfort and tranquility in your marriage, you need to replace the four deadly communication styles with healthy ones instead. Deadly communication style number one is criticism. This is when you attack the other person rather than complain about their behavior. The healthy alternative is a gentle startup. Avoid saying you, which can indicate blame, and instead talk about your feelings using I statements. Also, express what you need in a positive way. A simple two-step formula for a gentle startup is to answer these questions. 1. What do I feel? And 2. What do I need? For example, criticism would sound like this. You always talk about yourself. Why are you always so selfish? Instead, a gentle startup would sound like this. I'm feeling left out of our discussion and I need to vent. Can we talk about my day, please? Deadly communication style number 2 is contempt. This is when you treat the other person with disrespect and assume moral superiority over them. The healthy alternative is to build a culture of appreciation and respect. The more regularly you express appreciation, gratitude, affection, and respect for your partner, the less likely it is that you will feel or express contempt. In fact, for a relationship to succeed, it must have at least 5 or more positive interactions for every 1 negative interaction. For example, contempt would sound like this whilst rolling one's eyes. You forgot to load the dishwasher again? You are so incredibly lazy. Instead, a culture of appreciation and respect would sound like this. I understand that you've been busy lately. However, could you please remember to load the dishwasher when I work late? I would really appreciate it. This alternative shows that you know that the other person's actions aren't out of malice or laziness, is a respectful request, and ends with a statement of appreciation. Deadly communication style number 3 is defensiveness. This is usually a counter-attack to receiving a complaint. The healthy alternative is to take responsibility. Admit your role in the disagreement, even if it is only for part of the conflict. Here is an example of a complaint. Did you call your parents to let them know that we're not coming tonight as you promised this morning? Defensiveness would sound like this. I was too busy today. You know how busy my timetable is. Why didn't you just do it? Nothing pleases you. Instead, taking responsibility would sound like this. Oops, I forgot. I am sorry. I should have asked you this morning to do it because I knew my day would be too busy. Let me call them right now. Deadly communication style number 4 is stonewalling. This is when you shut down during a discussion or argument and stop responding to your partner. The healthy alternative is to practice physiological self-soothing. Stop the argument and request a timeout. Agree beforehand on a signal that you both can use to respectfully request a break whenever you feel overwhelmed. The timeout should last at least 20 minutes because it will take that long before your body physiologically calms down. During the timeout, avoid thoughts of righteous indignation such as, I don't have to take this anymore, or thoughts of innocent victimhood such as, why is he always picking on me? Instead, spend your time doing something that will help to calm you down, like reading or exercising. An example of practicing physiological self-soothing would sound like this. I'm sorry to interrupt this conversation, but I'm feeling overwhelmed and I need to take a break. Can you give me 20 minutes, please, and then we can talk? These 4 alternatives will allow you to manage conflict in a healthy way and help you to find comfort and tranquility in your marriage, inshallah. Da 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 da
da da da da da da da da.